too wide, I don't get a kickback with the mace material on the left side of the blade. We'll remove the plexiglass on this side and we'll put a straight edge against the side of a high blade. How this does not happen. We'll remove the plexiglass on this side, put the straight edge against the splitter and the gauge of a high blade. The splitter extends past the last teeth of a high blade for a distance of 5 inches. The gauge of the saw blade and the gauge of the splitter are slightly thinner than the width of the carbide tips. So any upward force in the back is caused by the fraction of the carbide tips that extend past the thickness of the splitter. That is all the force that lifts at the back, which is very minimal. At the front, there is still downward force forcing the material down onto the worktop. So with the straight line of the splitter and the straight on the inserts, we have 0 clearance slots. If these slots get a little bit wide, then it's an easy thing to replace the insert and make new slots. On the guard, there is a 0 clearance slot too, and if that gets too wide, we just make a new guard system. It's quite easily done. Also, the inserts sit inside the aperture and make the top a coplanar surface, which makes it all flat. All the safety devices are up front and they're more than adequate. If there is anything on natural wood that bends and comes together after you do the slot for the cut, then we always go and press the air switch on and off very quick. If there is a binding, all the safety devices will hold the material down. And as I explained here, there's no lifting force here to throw the waste material back at me. So this system is very safe.